When you think of Apify, one of the first things that likely comes to mind is web scraping. And this makes sense, since Apify is a web scraping service first and foremost. But Apify's platform also supports RPA use cases. Many RPA developers tend to assume that enterprise-focused automation vendors, UiPath, Automation Anywhere, etc., are the only viable options for strong automation programs. But in this tutorial, we'll see that Apify offers features that rival the RPA industry leaders, at a significantly lower price than the industry leaders charge. Let's use Apify to automate a business process. Suppose that every day we need to create a PDF file of every new item on an online store. To do this, we need to go to the online store and navigate to the new arrivals section. Then navigate to and save every page as a PDF. Finally, merge these PDFs into one combined file, using Adobe or other PDF software. Doing this manually every day is as tedious as it sounds. But Apify is more than capable of handling this entire process, so that no one has to do it manually ever again. Let's see how we can use Apify to automate this process. First, we'll create a new actor and choose the Playwright and Chrome template in Python. Before we start developing the solution, we need to make some adjustments to the template's files to support our RPA process. In the requirements file, we'll add a new dependency, RPA framework. This package provides several libraries for automating browsers, desktop applications, file types, operating systems, and web services. One of these libraries, the PDF library, will come in handy very shortly. The input schema and README should also be updated to describe the process being automated, and any inputs the process may require. This process does not have any inputs, so we'll delete the input schema's properties and requirements. Now comes the fun part, writing our code to automate this process. To keep things simple, we'll write everything in main.py. But keep in mind that for larger RPA projects, we should write our process steps in separate py files, and then import these steps into main.py. We'll remove most of this file's boilerplate code, so that we just have our imports and main method. The only import we need to add is the PDF library we mentioned before, so that we can use one of its methods later on. Next, we'll create two variables, one for the name of our final merged file, and one containing the URL of the online store. Note that instead of creating these variables, you could also create a config file that contains all your constants and settings. Using a config file is highly recommended for larger RPA projects. To kick things off, we'll start Playwright by launching Chromium, creating a page, and navigating to the online store. Note that we're using the asynchronous version of Playwright, so when we call a Playwright method, we need to await its result. Now that we're on the store's website, we need to determine how many pages we need to print. Looking at the website, we see that the page count is at the bottom of the page. Using inspect element, we can find a reliable selector to uniquely identify this element. We'll use this selector in our Playwright locator to grab the HTML element as a variable. To get the page number from this element, we get the element's text content, split the string to get the page number, and convert this number to an integer. Now that we have the total number of pages, we're able to loop through these pages and export each one to a PDF file. We could do this a number of ways. For example, we could repeatedly click the next button until we run out of pages. But there is a simpler way to do this. If we look at the URL, we can see that the page number is actually treated as a URL query parameter. This means that we can simply use the page.goto method and plug the next page number into our URL without having to worry about more selectors. To save each page as a PDF, we wait for the network to be idle so that all images can load. Then we use the page.pdf method. We'll provide some arguments that improve how the PDF looks. Most importantly, the path argument indicates the filename we should use for our saved PDF. The first time through the loop, the filename will be 1.pdf, then the second time is 2.pdf, and so on. After this loop finishes, we will have multiple PDF files, one for each page. To merge these all together, we can use RPA Framework's PDF library to merge all our individual files into one combined file. For the files argument, We use a list comprehension to create a list of all the PDF file names we created earlier. The last step is uploading our merge file to Apify's storage, so that we can access it after the run completes. Apify's key value stores make this incredibly simple. All we need to do is provide the file buffer and the MIME type. Let's save, build, and start this actor to see what happens. As we can see, the run succeeded, so let's check the storage tab and see what our merged file looks like. Viewing the file in our browser, it looks good. If you want to change how the PDF looks, you can modify the arguments we provided to the page.pdf method earlier. There's one last thing we need to do. Let's set a schedule for this so that it runs every day. In the Schedules tab, we'll create a new schedule and we'll choose daily. Apify allows schedules to be incredibly specific, but we'll simply leave this as default. Finally, we'll add our actor to the schedule. We won't provide any input, and we'll keep the options at their default values. We'll click Save and activate, and now our actor will generate PDFs for us every day without us having to lift a finger. This tutorial is just the beginning of what Apify and RPA framework are capable of doing. Apify has many more features you can use, and RPA framework has many more libraries to handle almost any RPA scenario. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and hopefully I've convinced a few of you to consider Apify for your unattended RPA needs.